English as a language is very important. Apart from it being a subject in our schools and colleges, it is the official language in many countries and is the most widely used spoken language. So if you focus on the subject right from your school days, it will greatly benefit you in your future. So without wasting any time, let's see some important points that are to be kept in mind while writing your English exams. Drawing margins are not of great importance when it comes to English paper, as we do not have to do any calculations or rough work. You may draw a very narrow margin on the right side. Please note, this is again optional. While writing, please keep your alignments proper. That is, start everything from the left and write everything one below the other very neatly. Write the question numbers correctly and start a new question on a new page. But you may continue the sub-questions one after the other. Leave a line after each answer. Write your answers considering the marks. That is, if it is a 1 or 2 mark question, please keep your answers short and precise. Don't write paragraph after paragraph. See the word limit and marks while writing the answers. In language paper, importance is given to neat presentation and handwriting. So keep a steady speed and a good handwriting throughout. Also, it is preferred to write the answers section-wise in the correct order, as it will be easier for the examiner to check your paper. But if you feel like attempting the second section first, you may leave the required space for the first section and start with the second one. Please be careful while doing that and don't mix up between sections. Okay, now let's see some section-wise tips. May it be any board or grade, English paper is majorly divided into 4 sections, as you can see here. Section 1, which is the reading section. When a passage or comprehension is given, students normally read the passage twice, thrice and waste a lot of time. Instead of doing that, read the questions first and try to register the keywords. Then you read the passage and check for their keywords and there you find your answers. If there are questions to complete the statements, write the entire statement and underline the answer. For do as directed questions, write the question and its correct answer. If there is a personal response question, try to answer it in a positive way. Now coming to section 2, here again you have to do the same thing. First take a quick glance at the questions and then carefully read the poem. Here, knowing the figure of speech, rhyming words and rhyme scheme is very important. There will be a sure shot question on these topics, so be thorough with that. Talking about section 3, one of the best ways of learning grammar and vocabulary is reading or speaking in English. One must also know the various rules for solving the do as directed part. If you find the section difficult, then I would suggest you to read and practice more and more questions. Vocabulary is the key to powerful writing. So learn new words, understand their meaning and their usage in speaking and writing. Section 4, writing skills. This is a section which most students find difficult as the topics are not known to them and they have to think and write. Again, a variety of questions can be asked and each answer has a fixed format. You can enhance and prepare yourself by reading the newspaper and other related articles for any current event. You may also refer some books for various topics of essays. Also, learn some quotes or few stanzas of poems by famous authors so that you may start your essay with that. It's a very nice way to impress your examiner. Think of some general scenario like various seasons, the thrill of the first rain, or your experience of a hot sunny day, any scenery, nature, or any uncertain event that you have faced, etc., as you can wisely fit them anywhere you want. You may even describe a person, a particular situation, or even show some conversation between two people to increase the length of your essay. Okay, Now let's move forward and see some rules for various questions asked in the writing skills. First, talking about letter writing. In case of informal letters, we have to write the sender's address and the date on the right-hand corner. Please check the alignment. The next important thing is the salutation, which is basically written on the left-hand side. Then comes the main body. Write the letter in different paragraphs. Use simple and short statements and complete the letter in a logical flow. Like there has to be an introduction. The middle paragraph should convey why the letter is written. And at the end, there should be a concluding paragraph. At the end comes the subscription part, where you politely end the letter, put a comma at the end, and your name. If the name is not mentioned, you may write XYZ. Okay, now coming to formal letters. First, we write the sender's address at the top right corner of the page with the date at the end. Again, see the alignment. Then we write the receiver's address on the left hand corner. Here please note, we write it as 2, comma, on the next line, the secretary or the principal, the commissioner, and followed by their address. Next and very important thing is the subject, the reason why you're writing the letter. We write it this way. You may even underline it to give more emphasis. Then comes the salutation part, followed by the main body of the letter, which has to be short, clear and precise. There has to be a complimentary closing, like this, thanking you in anticipation, thank you for taking the time to read the letter, etc. Then at the end comes the subscription with the sender's name. Please note, never use apostrophe with yours in the subscription. Also note, if you're writing a letter for a job application, please don't forget to box your resume. Okay? Let's now see the format for notice writing. First, in the center of the page, you have to write the name of the school, institution or company. Then you write notice, all in capitals in the center. Then you mention the date in this format. Okay, followed by a title, which basically should be relevant and eye-catching. Then comes the main body, which should cover all the information like what, when, where, from whom, etc. Again, be very specific and precise. At the end, you have to write the name and the designation of the issuing authority. Normally, it is given in the question itself. Okay. Moving forward to the format of report writing. A report is a brief or complete note of a past event. You first give the heading, followed by the writer of the report. Both these to be written at the center. Then towards your left, you will write the place and date. Then comes the main body. Write in paragraphs. Be brief and to the point. If it is based on an event, then report it in the order in which things happened, and it should be written in past tense as it is a completed event. Okay, that's it for report writing. Now, the preferred format for dialogue writing is like this, where you're showing conversation between two people. Indent the paragraph for different speakers. As you're showing a direct dialogue, use all the punctuations correctly and involve a variety of statements in your conversation. Now, if a question is asked to expand an idea or write an essay, select those topics which you have some prior knowledge of so that you can write better about it and you don't waste a lot of time thinking. Like I said earlier, start with a quote or a poem to create a good impression. And then you may continue the topic in different paragraphs. Okay? Again, please check the word limit and marks and write it accordingly. Moving to the next topic of story writing. If the start of the story is given, keep it that way and then frame a series of logical events and try ending it on a positive note. And if the end of the story is given, then depending on the conclusion, you have to develop a plot justifying that end. Here, giving a relevant title and writing the moral of the story is very important. Okay, don't forget that. So friends, these were a few formats for writing skills and some general tips to present your English paper. I hope the video was helpful to you.
मेरी तरफ से एक बार और आप सभी को best of luck. अगर आप लोगों को किसी और टाइप की वीडियो चाहिए तो प्लीज कमेंट करें और इस वीडियो को लाइक करें और अधिक से अधिक शेयर करें. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.